Bobby said, son, you're gonna drive into drinking if you don't stop driving that hot rod liquor. Have you heard the story of the hot rod race with the Fords and Lincolns was setting the pace? That story is true, I'm here to say I was driving that Model A. It's got a Lincoln motor and it's really souped up. That Model A body makes it look like a pup's got 8 cylinders and uses them all. Got his drive just when it starts. With a 4-barrel car and a dude exhausted, all in the future can really get lost. I've seen the tubes, but I ain't scared. The brakes are good, the tires fair. Pulled out of San Pedro late one night, the moon and the stars were shining bright. We was driving up a great fine hill, passing car, but they were standing still. All of a sudden in the wake of an eye, the cat lights are down past the sky. Sick boys at the mark for me, by then the tail light was all you could see. Now the fellas have ripped me for being behind, so I thought I'd make the Lincoln unwind. So my foot off the gas and man alive, I shut it all down to temple drive. Wound it up to 110.
What we have is a 1972 Honda 600 sedan. We have the original owner's manual, and also the dash has some interesting things on the gauges. And the shifter now is in the floor. It's attached to a C6 Ford transmission. The ignition switch is the factory Honda ignition switch with the little green toad frog that came with it when I bought it. And also it has a 1950 F100 steering box going through the wheel well. We have the original turn signal switch is still operating. It has a quick release steering wheel. And the instrument panel, everything works, even the speedo. I mean everything, the fuel gauge, the horn. The interior is still retaining all the original buckets and rear seat in good condition. That is an Army half shelter cut down and made into a hood, engine covering. Also, it's got a steel package tray. It has a nice sunroof. And even the interior door panels are aluminum and look real good. Also, I was wanting to look too at the brake pedal. The brake pedal is the factory Honda brake pedal turned upside down and mounted on the side of a 1928 Model A frame. And attached to it is a 1965 F100 brake boost, brakes master cylinder. It has Hoosier vintage racing tires. It has the Lincoln 1995 Lincoln airbags or air springs attached to the factory 1995 rear disc, Lincoln rear end. What we see here is the battery box. And inside the trunk now, it suits an ATI fuel cell. It's 12 gallons. Fuel gauge does work. The exhaust headers or lake headers are handmade. And on the inside, it does have baffles. They're boat baffles for a big block Chevrolet. Has a Chevrolet GM alternator, GM ATI distributor, Holley 750 dual line. And now all that's attached to a 460 Ford Board 60 overbalanced and blueprinted. Has a 65 Ford Mustang radiator. It's a 3-core. Also, all the mounts on this thing are transdap. The radiator cowl is 1947 Alice Chambers tractor grill. And the headlights are Model A Ford truck headlights. The front axle is a 1941 car axle. And that is dropped 8 inches suicide. It's got GM disc and GM pattern wheels on the front. The steering arm, the rod, the control arm is a 600 Ford tractor. It has a 47 Ford car pitman arm. And man, I tell you what, I like the way The long trailing arms, this thing really bites and goes. It's got a little peep mirror, and I tell you what, it's just a good riding, handling car, and I really enjoy it. And we're going to fire it up and drive it into the shop, okay?
My pappy said, son, we're going to be driving and drinking if you don't stop driving that hot rod Lincoln. Have you heard the story of the hot rod race we performed in the Lincoln Pacific Coast? That story is true on the Lincoln Missouri. I was driving that model A. It's got a Lincoln motor and it's really souped up. That model A body makes it look like a puck. Got 8 cylinders on, used them all, got overdrive, just won't stall. With a 4-barrel carb and a dual exhaust, with 4 living gears, you can really get lost. Got safety tubes, but I ain't scared.